Okay, it's Childish Gambino, homegirl, drop it like the NASDAQ. Move white girls like this coat up my ass.
So I'm sitting here with Childish Gambino at Big Day Out in Melbourne. Thanks so much for joining me.
No, thank you for having me.
So you've been in Australia for a little bit of time now, touring Big Day Out. How have you found it?
I really, really like it here.
Yeah?
I really like it here. Yeah, we went to Gold Coast. I went surfing for the first time.
Really? Did you actually get up on the board?
I didn't. I tried to get up like twice. Like the waves were really choppy.
Yeah.
So I tried to get up and I like stood up and I fell off. And then a wave was coming and I didn't get up in time. But I like surfed on my stomach like all the way down. And it was like a smooth like shh.
Yeah.
And
I was like, a good feeling, right?
It's a really great feeling because you're like, oh, I like caught it.
Yeah.
Like you can totally feel when you did it right. You know? But it's been great. Like everywhere we've gone has been like really cool.
So this is the second last Big Day Out here in Melbourne. You've got one more. How has it been touring the country doing Big Day Out?
I mean, it's been just really great. I mean, I wish all tours were kind of like this. It's, I guess coming to a country for the first time and just seeing your fans is a really cool experience, but also just like you've never seen any of the people or the animals or anything before, and like the great thing about Big Day Out is there's like time between the shows so you can visit and like
actually
go out. Usually like tours are like, oh, you get a day off, and it's really that day off is really just like you're either sleeping or washing your clothes. So it's been really like cool to like actually have days off.
Yeah, no surprises then, no crazy Australian creatures or anything like that.
I've been told to watch out for drop bears.
they're pretty dangerous.
I haven't seen any like I haven't seen a kangaroo up close yet, or a koala.
You should.
I heard the koalas they have chlamydia, so I was told to stay away.
Yeah, it's they're a dangerous breed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just wanted to stay away.
Because obviously you've never been to Australia before for this. Were you worried that when you came here that maybe some of the references wouldn't translate, or that the music wouldn't translate?
I guess a little bit, yeah, because I don't know really, you know, like they do. We speak English here, but, you know, I use a lot of idioms and references and just, like, weird, you know, stuff in my raps. So I didn't know if it would translate, but I guess it does.
I guess we're pretty Americanized here, though.
Yeah, I mean, you guys' television and everything is just, like, very American, and, like, the stuff is, everything is, like, the media is, you guys are, like, your media is also American.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it just works.
Yeah. Along with doing Big Day Out, you've also been playing a bunch of sideshows.
Mm-hmm.
I was lucky enough to see the one in Melbourne, which was amazing. Oh. It totally went off.
I'm glad you liked it.
Yeah, it was amazing. How have you found the sideshows?
Sideshows have been really nuts. Like, both of them sold out really fast.
Yeah, they really did. It was like 10 minutes or something.
Yeah, 10 minutes. So, like, we were expected. Like, I was really excited. And I mean, honestly, like, at first I was a little shocked, because I just didn't expect people here to like, you know, listen. Like, we're just kind of like, I'm it's so small time, like I was just like messing around, and so I didn't expect people to like have heard it. But the shows have been just like phenomenal, like all of them, like people are really excited and the energy's there. So I just want to try and like give it to them, because like I know we won't be back for at least until the next album's done, so I want to give them their money's worth.
Do you think that that your music, especially like, do you think that it translates better to a festival setting, or do you prefer to actually do the sideshows? Because the sideshows, they feel really like intimate.
Well, we changed the set for the show. Like, I feel like, you know, every show is different and every show should be an experience like that is like, could not be duplicated. So, you know, like the sideshow, we did like three freestyles for the sideshow, and we don't have as much time for these shows, so these shows tend to be just like the really fast, like energy filled songs, and the ones with the sideshow I like to do like the slower songs like LES or something, or So Fly, which we haven't done in a long time.
That was incredible.
Yeah, we haven't done So Fly in, I'd say, like, maybe this whole year. Like, I mean, like, well, even last year, part of it. Like, we haven't done it in a long time. But we were like, oh, this would be something that, you know, will be, like, intimate.
Yeah.
So you want to make each one feel like it's a big deal. So, yeah.
So you've talked a bit about in the past how hip-hop should still be a fun thing. you know, and that a lot of people kind of tend to take it a little bit seriously. Do you think that might be changing now?
It's weird. Like, lately I haven't even been thinking about hip-hop, like, as in hip-hop. Like, I think it's you're short changing yourself. If it's just like, what is rap? What is hip-hop? How is this? I just kind of look at it as, like, you know, how do I make people understand, like, what I'm feeling the best?
Yeah.
That's all I've done. Like, I think if you try and look at everything through a lens, that I try and look at everything through the lens of, like, a child. Like, I try and not have any preconceived notions about anything. So I feel like going into, like, the next album, or going into, like, anything, like, or how are people going to see me from the rap's point of view, is just kind of like just hurting me. Like,
yeah.
I just be like, I think it's just, it wouldn't help. So I think definitely things are in hip hop are changing. Everything's always changing in music, no matter what. And, you know, the more that we have, like, technologies where a kid can pick up, you know, like, I think Joey Badass is a perfect example of a kid who's, like, you know, just because he had like a computer, he was able to do something really cool and interesting, and he's so young. And I think the more that happens, the more variety we're gonna get. So
yeah, especially because it's so much more accessible now.
Yeah, it's so accessible and it's cheap, and you can do it and do it well.
Yeah.
So I think I try not to look at it as like, what does hip hop need or anything like that. It's just like, what am I feeling?
So what are you feeling right now? What are you listening to?
Jesse Ware.
Yeah.
We're listening to Jesse Ware. I was listening to a lot of London stuff, like Jesse Ware, Sampha, you know, Subtract, those guys. But also, I was listening to Tame Impala, actually.
So you like some Aussie music?
Oh, yeah. Tame Impala's the shit. Like, they're so dope. And what was I listening? Oh, I listened to Future's new mixtape a lot.
Yeah?
Yeah. I really like Future's new mixtape. And I listened to Gunplay's new mixtape. You know, just like going back and listening to old stuff like Al Green and stuff. But that's basically what's in the mix right now. I was listening to Monica too.
Really?
Yeah, I was listening
to,
like, oh my gosh. Yeah, I think I got into it. I was listening to Anita Baker, and then I was like, what's that song? Kind of feels like a, and then it was like, Before You Walk Out of My Life song.
Yeah.
And The Boy Is Mine. Like, I was like, those were like good days. Those were like fun songs.
Everything felt smooth back then.
Everything was very smooth. Like, yeah. I was like, man, I'll never be that smooth.
You've done some pretty amazing collaborations in your time, including one with Miss Tina Fey.
Yes.
Did that come about from your writing on 30 Rock?
I mean, it definitely...
It helped?
It definitely helped. Knowing her definitely helped her get her on the track. I didn't even see it as a collab. I just thought it was a good... It was just kind of a weird layer to put on top, just like, because I was like, well, that song is about something that I think is more me, and then Alley Boy's on it, and he's like, you know, a little more like hardcore Atlanta, like southern rap, and I was like, man, it would be kind of weird and cool to have like Tina Fey talking shit at the end. And then we were kind of joking about it, and then we're like, yeah, let's just do that. And then, like, our mixer, Chris Carmouche, who lives in, like, Atlanta, he does, like, all the Outkast stuff. He was like, that shit is fly. I love it. So I was like, yeah, I guess I got to leave it on there. She's, you know, talking stuff.
Stamp of approval, then.
She's really good. I think she's just really good at it. She talks a lot of shit. Like, she's, like, really good at, like, I don't know, whenever she does it in the show, I would always get kind of a sick laugh because she's, like, really in your face.
Yeah.
So I thought it was cool.
She's not shy, is she?
No.
Not at all.
Tina is not shy.
So if you could do a collaboration with anyone, because obviously Tina Fey is off the list, so anyone else?
Either, like, Prince or Basquiat. Like, those are the two. I really like those guys. Like, Prince a lot. Just because I feel like they're really...
Did you like the new Prince song that just came out?
Oh, there's a new Prince song?
Yeah, it came out a couple days ago.
No, I didn't hear about it. See, I'm so far away from everything.
I know. Well, we do have the internet here.
It's slow, though, sometimes.
It is slow.
It's super slow.
So, Royalty came out a little while ago, and it's been receiving pretty amazing feedback from fans and critics and everything. How was the recording of that?
We did a lot of it on the bus.
Really?
We did a lot of it on the tour bus. Like, I made a bunch of beats, like the Unnecessary beat. Like, I know a lot of people really like that song. And I was really proud of it, but, like, I swear, like, I didn't make that song. Like, I woke up, like, if there's a God, like, he made that song. Because I woke up and, like, that song was in my head and I made that beat in, like, 15, 20 minutes.
Wow.
Wrote the verse, like, in 15, 20 minutes and then sent it to Absol and
that's incredible.
Schoolboy that day, and they were like, yo, yeah, we get on it, and they killed it. It was just all came together, you know, and then but most of the tracks were just recorded on the bus in my bus, like, closet,
and wow.
Put a bunch of, like, you know, towels and in the toilet room.
That's pretty lo-fi.
Like, yeah, so lo-fi, but it sounds all the same. That's what I'm saying. It's like, it sounds, you can mix it the right way, and, like, also I don't like it when things sound too clean, like,
yeah,
you know. But yeah, it just kind of all came together.
So have you got anything planned, like, special for Melbourne today?
I mean, if we run fast, like, I think, like, if we're running fast, we'll do, like, a special song. Like,
yeah.
Probably, hopefully, like, a song that we haven't done anywhere else. So that's always what we like to do, is, like, run really fast and then be like, how much time do we have? And then we'll be like, oh, we have 5 minutes. We're like, great, so we'll do, like,
do
a song that we
awesome.
Haven't
well,
done.
Well, we're
yet.
Really looking forward to it.
I'm really excited to be here. This is supposed to be, like, it's Australia Day, so, yeah.
Thanks so much for talking to
no
me.
No problem. Thanks for talking.